Hi guys, and welcome to the channel. Thank you for taking the time to stop by. Hopefully you're going to learn something like I am today. Now, what we've got is a lovely little pocket watch from Deacon and Sons. Now, Edwin Deacon was a prominent jeweller and a glass and china dealer in Luton, Bedfordshire. Now, he was born in 1842. And then he died in 1914 from pneumonia after catching a chill. He was the head of a firm, E Deacon and Sons, and they had a shop in 79 George Street, Luton. Mr. Deacon also owned number 77 George Street, which was occupied by his son-in-law, Arthur Marriott. He was also a watchmaker, but an optician as well. Now, it is a lovely little piece, very dirty, it doesn't run, as you can see. There's no movement in the balance, really. It's very, very dirty, so it does need a good clean. So, first things first, what we're going to do, let's get it out of the case. And to do that, we're going to remove any power that is left in the main spring. And then also, then we're going to remove the winding stem. Let the power down gently. Out comes the stem. A little bit dirty. Next thing we want to do is remove the bezel. Just like that. Give that a bit of a polish. I'm not too sure if this was gold plated at some point. You can see a little bit there in the colour, it's slightly gold. So once we've polished it, we'll have a look and then maybe we will re-silver the case. Next thing to do is take off the watch hands. Now those hands off and the stem removed, what we want to do, just turn it over, be very, very careful. And there's two retaining screws. I'm going to take these out. Just going to gently push the movement out. There we go, it's free from the case. Get that out of the way. Oh, got all of that there. Give that a good clean later. So the next thing to do is to get the dial off. So there's a dial screw there, is it? at that. Very sticky oil. I shall give that a good clean later. Lots of oil there, and around here. It's horrible. I say that, I'm looking forward to cleaning it. One on this side, what we will do is get rid of that cannon pinion, move that out of the way. Only just. Give all of these a bit of a pre-clean before I put it to the ultrasonic. But before we do any of that, first thing we're going to do to remove the balance wheel. We'll assess that properly once it's been through the wash. Now I'm going to do, I'm going to put a bit of a wind in it because I just want to have a little look to see if that pallet fork actually moves. Nope. See that there is no. Power getting through this train. Sounds solid. I'm trying to be careful because what I don't want to do is bend or break any pivots on the pallet fork itself. Okay, now that's something it shouldn't do. Stick to it like that. Give it all a clean, we'll have a proper inspect of the parts. It was almost jammed. So, I think a good clean is all it needs. Old grease and oil. Yeah.
Is swimming in some bits.
Remove the click spring. of
Cambridge. And the escape wheel there is trying to escape.
Just taking out the centre wheel there and the escape wheel. Second wheel. Third wheel. And then the barrel or the first wheel. Have a look at the spring shortly. Should be in two parts. Everything that side. Could be broken jewel. Now onto the keyless work side. Covered in all grease. Parts really shouldn't stick to your tweezers. Oops. Let's find out where that's gone. See, what I've learned is to use your pegwood aid. Use your pegwood. Okay, that's all dismantled.
Final thing is this capsule. And I'll try and find that spring that's just gone to outer space. And then put it all in the wash. Time to cream it off. Bit of baking soda, bit of water, pop the dial in. And away we go. Okay, unfortunately, my ultrasonic cleaner only does the ultrasonic cleaning, it doesn't do the heating. So my distilled water up there, I'll put into a glass jug, pop it into the microwave, and I'll warm it up. It's already got a bit of the cleaning solution. Where that will pop another cap full in. Like I say, all the parts I've had a pre-clean. I've actually taken out that broken jewel. What I will do is I'll try and film putting in the new one. Let's put them into the bath. It on, leave it on for half an hour. Start. Takes a little while to get going. While that's doing, we'll go and clean the case. Okay, so everything's clean. Your parts, the case, the new spring. It's all come out nice and clean. Time to put it all together. Okay, so everything's clean. Your parts, the case, the new spring. It's all come out nice and clean. Time to put it all together.
So everything's
been in the ultrasonic cleaner.
It's been in the ultrasonic cleaner. It's all clean.
Given the case a polish.
Now, first thing we need to do is replace that jewel.
I did take it out before.
Didn't clean it and didn't film it.
But all I did was to use a jewel pusher.
Pushed it through.
And then used. This little tool here.
To open up the hole slightly.
We'll use the other end.
To close it back up.
Once we've got the jewel in.
That's opened it up enough.
I've only ever done this a couple of times before.
I don't know how this is going to turn out.
Before I put the main spring in, what I'd like to do is just add a few dabs of grease into the barrel case.
Doesn't need a lot.
Usually it is cross-side up.
Grease on the barrel out of there. I'd like to install these
is get
a little pin vise pin vise just like that.
And then
it's doing that part. Much easier. Barrel lid.
Another
3D printed thing. Or mainspring.
Next thing we're gonna do.
Let's get movement.
Into a holder,
like so.
Okay, so first things first, we're going to get the trainer wheels on, or in, I should say. Before I put the mainspring barrel in, I'm just going to pop a little bit of oil in there, on there. Before this one goes in, we should put a little bit of oil on the centre pinion. Something quite often I do miss is the setting lever screw. Not this time. So that's the bridge on, and it's time to get this bridge on for the escape wheel and the second wheel. Free moving. Just using a bit of pegwood to make sure that it doesn't move anywhere and that they don't jump out of the jewel holes, the pivots. Once you've got one in, that'll hold it, it won't go anywhere, and for this second screw, you won't need to use the pegwood. And as you can see under the microscope, these screws are just a little bit scratched up, but I don't have anything. Well, so I don't have anything. I don't have the tools to polish screw heads yet. It's an investment I haven't made yet. Should we still free moving? It is. Lovely. Use what I've got, a bit of oil just there. Next, the spring. Goes a crown wheel. Flip it over. On the dial side.
Right. It is very creaky, I know.
Now this is the part responsible for allowing you to wind the watch one way, but not the other. All of this side here is called the keyless works as well.
In the early days of pocket watches, you used to have a key which you would carry around so you could wind it up. Any further, I'm going to get the cannon pinion on.
Reason for putting that on first is when you start putting some of the other wheels, the intermediate wheels and the like on, what you don't want to do is damage that when you push down like that.
Time to get the yoke spring in. Now this thing can go flying if you're not careful. And this kind of retaining bracket is next.
Clean up that excess grease.
Okay, so that's the keyless works on. Now, time to put that jaw back.
Okay, so that's pretty much on that side, except for the minute wheel and the lights once we do the dial. So next in is the pallet fork, and this is a jewel replacer. I do hope it fits. I measured the right one. Screw in pallet cock. Okay, so we've got the pallets in. Now it's time for the pallet spring. Let's see if this thing will fire up, which I'm hoping it will. Now we've changed that jewel. There's life. Now I have made a bit of an error in cleaning this dial. If anybody can see what it is, please leave a comment. Let me know what's missing.
Let me know what's missing.
Needless to say, I thought you would. Needless to say, I thought it would be the same as the numbers on the dial, but by all accounts it's not. So I'm pretty annoyed, to be honest, but there's nothing I can do to fix that now. This is the trickiest of all hands. This is the second send.
There we have it.
Back together. Now just need to put it back into the case for that. Take out the winding stem.
Breeze to go in. And this just holds it into the case, stops it rattling around. Thank you for sticking around till the end. If you have liked that, please consider liking and subscribing, and leaving a comment also helps. And I'll see you on the next one. Goodbye.